Hey, welcome back, Options Traders, and a very special welcome to all of the new traders we've had join here this week. It's great having you here. And I wanted to pose a really good question, especially for all of you who write covered calls. And the question is, can you have a negative cost basis? Now, even though this video is talking about a specific strategy, it really is going to apply to any strategy. And it's something you have to be really careful of. So, take a shot. What do you think? Can you write yourself into a negative cost basis? Well, first, to understand what that means, let's look at the covered call again. Remember, this is a strategy where you're going to buy, let's say, 100 shares, and you will sell one call against that. And when you do that, you have the potential obligation to sell those shares for the strike price. So let's say that you buy 100 shares of stock and you spend $100, and you sell maybe the $100 call for $5. Now, it doesn't matter if it's an at the money, in the money, out of the money, you're just selling a call and collecting some premium. That's really the main point to understand. So in this example, we've spent $100 on the shares, we've received $5 from selling the call, so we would say that our cost basis is reduced to $95. In other words, we have effectively purchased the shares for $95, and that's going to reduce our cost basis as well. So the resulting risk graph will look like this. Here's the bend at the 100 strike that we wrote. Because we collected $5, that would be the maximum gain. We have no potential for capital gains because we sold the at-the-money strike. So the only money we make is from the extrinsic value. So the idea is, can you write yourself into a negative cost basis? So what this really means is that right now, we've got a cost basis of 95. Well, let's say that next week or next month, we write another call, first call expires worthless, or we buy it back for a very small amount, and we sell another call for, let's say, $5. And now we've got a cost basis of 90. And then maybe the following month, we sell another call for $5, and our cost basis is 85. And so this process just continues. And you hear traders talk about this a lot, especially with cheaper stocks, let's say a $30 stock, but that might have some volatility. So they're getting $2 or $3 for these options. And they say, oh, well, I've written myself into a negative cost basis. Well, that's really the question that we want to address. Can you continually sell calls until you have a negative cost basis? So the negative cost basis just means that we have eventually collected more in option premiums than we've spent on the shares. So in this example, if we initially spent $100 on the stock and we sell these options, and maybe we've now sold $105 worth of calls, we would say, okay, I've got a negative cost basis of $5. Well, is that really true? Can you write yourself into a negative cost basis? Well, like a lot of things with options trading, it depends on how you look at it. And what I really wanted to show you in this video is that you have to be really careful about talking about a negative cost basis. So for professional traders, they will always use what is called mark to market. We are going to mark this position, whatever it is in our account, to the current market price. And so what it turns out to be is that for the covered call, your cost of the shares is the market price. Now again, from an accounting standpoint or from a tax standpoint, that may not necessarily be true, but it's more from a trading or an investing standpoint that you have to consider your cost as the market price. Now why is that? Well, each time that you sell a call, you are choosing to not sell the stock. So think about it. Yeah, you might have spent $100 for the stock initially, and you've written a bunch of calls, but what if it's now trading for $300 or $500? Should you say that you've got a negative cost basis? Well, not really, because if you had the opportunity to sell the shares right now for a much higher price, but you're choosing not to, instead you're saying, I'm going to put these shares at risk again for another month and sell this call, we should really consider that current market price as the value of your shares. So again, from a professional trading standpoint, your cost is the stock's market price, regardless of what might be considered the mathematical price or the accounting price that you've actually paid. So no matter what you paid, you are risking the current market price. That's what's most important. So using this example, sure, you might have initially paid $100 and you might have initially sold a whole bunch of calls. Maybe you have a cost basis of 70, or maybe you've got a cost basis of negative 5. But right now, the stock is trading for 300. So if you were to write another call for $5, this would be your risk graph. See, now we have the bend at 300. So again, it doesn't matter if you paid 300 for it. The fact is you could have sold your shares right now for this amount. So by saying, nope, I don't care about that, I'm willing to write calls against it, then you are putting $300 worth of value at risk. And the reason that's an important consideration is look at where the risk is. It's to the downside. See, if you've got a cost basis of negative $5, is it fair to say that you have no risk in this position? Well, that's hardly true. This stock could fall a long way from 300, and this is your basically an unlimited downside risk. It's not going to feel like negative $5. So what this also means is that for your return calculations, you also have to be careful. Let's say that you did initially pay $100 for the stock, and you have, over the months here, collected $30 from selling calls. So yes, we might say from an accounting perspective, your cost basis has been whittled down to $70. Well, if the current market price, let's say, is $300, and you sell an at-the-money $300 call for $5, you really shouldn't say that your return is $5 divided by 70, or 7.1% for that month, because you have put $300 at risk. Your return for that month should be 5 divided by the current market price of 300, or about 1.7%. Now, sure, it's true on one hand we could say the percentages don't really matter, it's $5 regardless. What is probably the more important point is to recognize that in this example you have $300 of potential downside, not negative 5. And if you lose sight of that, you might end up stepping into some very dangerous traps by believing that you can have a negative cost basis. And so for anyone who'd like to learn more about the arts and science of options trading, please check out the Alpha Trader course, Strategy Lab, and a technical analysis course. It's all at optionsatoz.com. Also, please join us on the Facebook trading group, Options A to Z, and you can find a link in the description below.